गुड मॉर्निंग चंदन। यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड द लेसन दैट इज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस डे 1 एंड वी आर कंप्लीटेड फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 60 टू पेज नंबर 64 दैट इज व्हाट आर नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस एंड दैट टाइप्स ऑफ रिसोर्सेस दैट इज रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेस एंड सेकंड वन नॉन रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेस and then also we have completed solar energy and soil and today and also also about activities for which soil is used. Now today I am taking forest and then uses of the forest. So open page number 65 about forest. Let me tell you about forest.
So
first page number 65, look there, first para, forest. Forest are the natural habitat of the wild animals and the birds. Keep in mind, it is the one of the forest is one of the natural habitats. It is the place or home, habitat means place, safety place for wild animals and also for the birds. And forest provide the necessary food to animals and many useful materials to man. Forest, they provide food for animals, not only food for animals, even many useful things or the materials we get from the forest for human beings. So we get useful materials to us. And observe the pictures and make a list of uses of the forest. Here we can see in page number 65 here, we can see that we can build the houses in the forest, how it is built using wood. So this is a, we can build a house and we can make the furnitures. Understood? We get fruits, we can graze it, we can get resin from the different types of forest trees. Understood? Medicinal plants, baskets also can be made. So different uses are there from the related forest used us in the different place. Understood? Now let us see. And also we get honey from this honey we prepares honey and it is used for by our beings. Also we get different flowers which we are not. We get honey bee and also different flowers from the forest. Now let us see the how forest is used or uses of the forest. First point, forest is, it is the natural habitat. It is the natural habitat for wild animals. For wild animals and birds. For wild animals and birds. Secondly, forest is the shelter for not only this animals, also for tribal peoples living in forest. Then next, forest prevents soil erosion. Forest is trees prevent soil erosion. It is top soil is not wasted when there is heavy rain. Understood? Forest trees prevent soil erosion. Means they top soil is not be wasted or not flow away. Fourth point. Forest is forest is give, trees give oxygen, and increases its quantity and increases its quantity in the atmosphere. Also, forests also bring rains. Hence, forest dissection. Dissection of forest is dissection. 612. Hence, destruction of forest. Is destruction of life. So these are the different points on uses of the forest. These are the few uses of the forest. Now, look here. Know this, sir. Forests are also one of the natural resources, and they provide fruits, flowers, medicinal plants, wood, etc. Forests are the shelters for tribals. Forests prevent soil erosion. It is washing or blowing away of our topsoil. The trees give out oxygen and increase its quantity in the atmosphere. Such forests are valuable. Such useful and valuable trees are being destroyed for various human activities like urbanization, industrialization, construction of dams, etc. So we must not forget that destruction of forest is destruction of life. So in the due to destruction of forest or various human activities, and that is like industrialization, construction of dams and urbanization, what man is, because of the selfishness of man, he is cutting the forest, that is destroying the forest, and which destruction of forest, it leads to destruction of life of man. So you must not cut the forest or destroy the forest. Now, conservation of forest, page number 67. Conservation of forest. Forest can be conserved by, how to conserve it? By restricting unnecessary felling of the trees. By avoiding, restriction means to avoiding unnecessary felling of the trees. See that, and for the concerned persons must look after that unnecessary falling of the trees should be avoided, and trees planting should be done, proper using of forest products, and proper using of forest products, cutting down tree branches causing forest fire, etc. can avoid the cause. Can be by this we can avoid, we can do the conservation of forest. The government has been appointed to National Forest Policy 1988 and has been taken steps to nurture and conserve the forest. Many movements have been taken place against destruction of when implementation of several mega projects were proposed. And here, let us see this page number 69. Know this award. Award Salamurthy Thimmakka, a proud daughter of Karnataka, is known as Rukshmi Mate. Salamurthy Thimmakka, she is known as Rukshmi Mate. She is the proud daughter of the Karnataka, known as Rukshmi Mate, throughout the country. Daughter of Vijayamma and Chakra Nagaya of Gubbi Taluka. She is the daughter of she belongs to Gubbi Taluka in Tumkur district. Thimmakka was married to Bikkala Chikkaya of Hulikal village and stayed there. Later on, she has planted and protected berry trees beside the road from her village Hulikal to Kudur with the help of her husband. And considering these trees as her children, though she don't have children, she thought these trees are her own children, and Thimmakka dedicated her entire life for them. She has dedicated her entire whole life for the sake of for growing the trees. Dedicated means tyag. Hence, centenarian Thimmakka is called Salamurthy Thimmakka. And the government of Karnataka has declared a project called Salamurthy Thimmakka Neru Yojana in its budget 2014-15. Hundreds of awards have been conferred for her immense concern towards nature. The important awards are Nadoja Award, that is Karnataka University Hampi, and then she was given Nadoja Award from Hampi University, Karnataka Rajyotsava Award, Indira Priyadarshini Vrikshamitra Award, Government of Karnataka, and Parisara Ratna Award. So her role, she is a role model for all of us in the conservation of her environment. Now this animals are also renewable resources, because they enhance their population by agriculture. Animals are also called as a renewable resources. Why means sometimes hunting of the animals leads to extension of their race, thereby make them non-renewable sources. So it is our duty to conserve such resources. So keep in mind, we must not make them non-renewable. It is our duty to conserve such resources, because they are, animals are also natural resources or resources. So we must conserve such resources. Now, you have learned about renewable resources. Now let us know about the some non-renewable resources. About the non-renewable resources, that is fuels. Let us see about fuels. Fuels are substances which release heat and energy on burning. Now about fuels. Fuels means like petrol and diesel and natural gas and all that. Fuels are substances which release heat and energy on burning. We use fuel for many purposes. See, fuels are nothing but which release when we burn. On burning, they release heat and energy. And we use fuel for many purposes like running vehicles, cooking food and all. Name three fuels used to run vehicles. They are petrol, diesel and this LPG are used as a fuels to run the vehicles. Name three fuels used to cook food at home are, say again, kerosene, this charcoal, wood, LPG are used to cook the food. Wood is used, kerosene is used, and also LPG is used at home for cooking food. So, fossil fuels are found by remains of extinct plants and animals which were buried under the earth's crust for millions of years. So these are called fossil fuels. The main fossil fuels are petroleum and natural gas and coal. Coal means calendar one. Petroleum. Petrol, diesel, kerosene, wax, etc. are the byproducts of petroleum. Means by petroleum only These things are made. Petroleum is a liquid mineral formed beneath the earth. It is formed by the action of the bacteria, heat and pressure of dead organisms buried under the layers of the rocks. And the byproducts of petroleum like wax and paraffin are used in making candles, wood polish, ointments, dyes, lipsticks, chemical fertilizers, plastic, jelly, etc. Natural gas is found with the petroleum wells. CNG, that is compressed natural gas, is used as an alternative fuel to get petrol designed to run vehicles. Now coming to petroleum, next natural gas, these all come under non-renewable resources. Then coal, let us see about coal here. Millions of years ago, page number 71, millions of years ago, the remains of plants and trees that were buried beneath the earth's crust did not decay completely. And due to high temperature pressure, they turned into coal, that is caligula, what you call, under the layers of the earth. And this is used for fuel, in production of electricity, and this source of energy is also used in industries for heat purpose. Right, examples for the following. Solid fuels are coal. Liquid fuels are petrol, diesel and kerosene. Gaseous fuels are LPG. Understood? LPG is the gaseous fuel. Now know this, sir. Excess use of fuels is dangerous to the environment. Nowadays, efforts are being made to use alternative source of energy like solar energy. Now next, page number 72. Mineral resources. Let us see about this. Mineral resources. Minerals are formed in the page number 72. Minerals are formed in the earth as a result of long natural process, and they are available along with rocks on the surface of the earth. These are formed. How they are formed? Minerals, how they formed in the earth as a result of long natural process. Naturally, they are formed, and they are available along with rocks on the surface of the earth. They are available along with the rocks under the surface of the earth, and minerals are extracted in the form of ore. Minerals are mixed with ores. Means impure. Minerals are mixed with the ores and refined in factories. Metals are separated from them. Metals are separated from its ore. For example, separation of iron from iron ore. And like metals like aluminium, copper, silver, etc. are extracted from their ores. In this way, they are separated and made pure. Mineral means it is a multi-useful material, useful available in nature. And you can see the picture. With the help of iron only, we can prepare many of the things and also with the help of gold and silver, we can make ornaments which we wear. And know this, regaining of emptied mineral resources depends on the scientific process that take place inside the earth. Minerals are formed over millions of years, and they must be used moderately. Minerals should be used moderately, means not more or not less. Now here, we just saw last Let me tell you this in the next of the prayer. Now this completes about the forest, use of the forest and about the petrol, natural gas and the coal. So let me continue next prayer about the remaining things. Thank you.